Assalamu alaikum. How are you? I hope you people are all fine and you're taking care of yourself, and obviously you'll be studying as well. So here we have second lecture of geography, that is week 2 lecture. Again, we'll be continuing unit 1, which is the universe, from page number 3 of your world watch. This is your additional task and the plan according to which you are going to study during this week. On day 1, you will go through slide number 3 to 8, which comprises of page number 3 and 4 of your world watch 1. The topics which will be covered are the stars and galaxies. Your additional task will be, you'll do the task which is mentioned on slide number 9. That will be your day 1 task. And obviously, I'll be asking you about this task in the Zoom class. You have to bring along, your work. Then on day 2, you can go through slide number 10 to 15, which is covering how did our solar system form. And it's on page number 4 of your World Watch 1. Do perform the activity which is mentioned to understand the concept of gravity. Bring your results along with you. What did you learn through that activity? And do the tasks which are mentioned on slide number 16. That is your day 2 homework. Then day 3 is for your written work. Your written work is mentioned on slide number 17. Please note down any questions you are unable to answer. Discuss those questions with me in the Zoom class and then revise the question answers and the things we have covered on day 3, right? This is your work for day 3. Let's start with the warm-up activity. You people can perform this activity on your own. Roll the dice, see which number comes, and then perform the respective task which is given against each number. We'll definitely be doing this activity in Zoom class as well. Let's just go through week 1 lecture. In week 1, we studied about the stars and constellations. I told you people that stars are the masses of burning gases. They shine brightly because they are composed of gases, mainly hydrogen and helium. Then we also studied about the constellations, which are the patterns made by the stars, and you people performed one activity as well. We also try to understand the difference between star and the constellation. Then we studied about nebula, and you people must be remembering about the term nebulae. What is a nebula? Nebula is a cloud of dust, rocks and gases, and we also studied about Orion nebula, which can be seen from the Earth. Secondly, the role of nebula is obvious in the formation of a star and the planets, and we studied about the formation of star in last week's lecture. In this lecture, we'll study about the formation of the planets, but the role of nebula is vital in the formation of a star and the planets. And we also studied that the gases which are there in the nebula, they form the star. So this is what we did last week. You have to take 10 minutes, go through page number 2 and 3, whatever we have done last week, so that you know it's easy for you to continue with today's lecture. Today's learning objectives are, we'll study more about the universe, we have already studied about the stars, now we'll focus upon the movement of the stars, we'll study about galaxy, what is a galaxy, the difference between nebula and galaxy. We'll know more about the formation of the solar system. How did the planets form? Though we have already studied about the formation of the star, now we'll study about the formation of the planets. Knowing about the planets and the role of gravity in space, obviously we'll be discussing this term as well with the help of the activity. I'll make you understand what is gravity. Then names of the planets of the solar system in an order. Obviously you'll be learning them and you'll learn them in an order. Alright, our next topic is, though my next question is, do you think stars move? Yes or no? Let's see. Do you know that it appears as if stars are fixed and they do not move, but actually the stars move and their movement takes millions of years. Okay, they take millions of years to change their position. Now, some astronomers say that the stars move around the Earth in the same way. Okay, now see, Earth is also moving, and the stars are also moving. So the positions relative to one another, the position of the stars and the position of the earth, they stay same to one another. This is one assumption you can say. Okay, some astronomers, early astronomers, they noticed that some of the stars in the sky, they move in groups, right? If there is one constellation, so that proper constellation is moving together. That is another reason that from the earth we hardly can recognize the movement of the stars. But the major reasons are, they are mentioned in your book on page number 3 as well, that stars do move. But the first reason is, why can't we observe their movement? Number one, they're very far from the earth. They're so far from the earth that we can hardly notice their movements. And number two is that, they move in the groups, they move in the clusters. And number three, third assumption is that the earth is also moving and the stars are also moving. So their position relative to each other stays the same. I have an activity over here for you people. Do this activity to understand how, is it that we do not observe the movement of the stars. What are you going to do is, cut one star from a chart paper, right? A star shaped chart from chart paper. Hang it on height. I would suggest you wear, either hang it with the ceiling fan with a thread, but don't turn on the ceiling fan, okay? Or you can hang it with some hook somewhere, but make sure that you are able to sit under it, right? You are able to sit under it. Take a chair and sit under it. Now, this is your activity. Fix a star which is made up of chart paper on height and sit under it on a chair, right? Exactly under it. Make sure you are sitting exactly under it. Now, move the chair the way we move it in a circle. Move the chair, turn the chair to different positions, making sure that you are still under the star. Okay, keep yourself under the star, but change your position of the chair in a circle. It's just like you're changing the position of the chair, demonstrating the earth is rotating, the earth is moving. Okay, and the star is at height. Okay, and you, what are you going to observe is that you will observe that the star is always above the chair. Though you are moving in a circle, you're moving your chair, but star is always above the chair. What does this activity show? This activity shows that it's just like when the earth rotates. The way you are rotating sitting on the chair, you are moving sitting on the chair, is just like the earth rotates. Okay, but when you talk about the pole star, okay, that is above the north pole, when the earth rotates, the star is always above the north pole. There is one star which is towards the North Pole. We call it as North Star. Okay. In the next chapter, we have a topic how to locate that star. So we'll study it in the next chapter. So you can demonstrate it in this way, that there are many stars in the sky which actually move, but they appear to be at the same position because of the fact the earth is rotating as well and the stars are moving as well. So the relative positions to each other, they stay the same, right? Do this activity and bring that star that you have cut. I would recommend you to hang it where you are planning to have your Zoom lesson, so that we can do this activity in our Zoom class, right? So note down the second task which we are going to do in the Zoom classes. We'll do this activity in the class and I'll explain you over there as well, though I'll ask you, right? You people are going to explain me. We'll do this activity. Now comes the topic which is about galaxies. What are galaxies? First of all, we'll define galaxy. Galaxy is a collection of stars. Galaxies having stars in it. It has nebulae. Remember, nebulae is the plural. And other materials which are held together by galaxies' gravity. Earlier, we discussed that nebula has gravity as well. So, in the same manner, galaxies also have the center of gravity. All the objects which are present in the space have force of gravity. And because of that force of gravity, all the objects stay at their positions. If they're moving, they keep on moving in their orbits. Okay, so gravity is of great importance. So gravity is a collection of stars, nebulae, and other materials which are held together by galaxies' gravity. This definition is given on page number 3 under the heading of galaxies. Now, as we have discussed about this gravity over here, I have to mention the definition of gravity over here as well. Gravity is the force that pulls objects in space towards each other. Okay, and this definition is mentioned on page number 5 of your books, though we have not read it, but it's given over there in It's a Fact. It is the first point. Okay, please underline this first point. Gravity is the force that pulls objects towards another body having mass. It is given on page 5, It's a Fact. Please underline it. Now, there is a galaxy whose name is Large Magellanic Cloud. Large Magellanic Cloud is the nearest galaxy, okay, the nearest galaxy from us, and it was discovered by a Persian astronomer whose name was Abdul Rahman Sufi. He was a Muslim. And if you want to look at Large Magellanic Cloud galaxy, please look at your books, page number 3. It's given over there, Large Magellanic Cloud galaxy. It is the nearest galaxy, which was discovered by Abdul Rahman Sufi. All these points are given, okay, on page number 3. Now, our galaxy is the Milky Way. Okay, there are so many galaxies in the universe. The one which belongs to us is the Milky Way. Which one is it? The Milky Way. Now, our Milky Way is the galaxy, and our star is the Sun, the major star. Though there are many stars, but one of the major stars is the Sun. And remember one more thing, smaller galaxies, they orbit the bigger galaxies. All the objects which are smaller in size, they orbit the bigger ones. Why? Because the bigger objects have strong center of gravity, right? Well, what is an orbit? Because we have studied over here, we have just discussed that smaller galaxies orbit the bigger galaxies. So what do we mean by orbit? That is also important. Orbit is the path of a planet. Remember, it is not the actual path, it is an imaginary path. Okay, the path of a planet or other heavenly body in the universe which is traveling around a star or any other body in space is known as the is the orbit. Like planets orbit the star, the Sun, in their specific, on their specific paths. Those specific paths are known as the orbits. Now, what are you going to do is, the definition of galaxy is given on the book. I'll make you underline with the help of the next slide. The definition of gravity is given on page number 5. It's a fact. Please underline that definition. Okay. Then these points are also given. Large Magellanic Cloud is the name of the galaxy. I'll show you in the next slide. The definition of orbit is not written. Okay. Over here. So you can write down the definition of orbit over here on page number 3 with the topic galaxies. One more thing, there are some definitions which are given at the back of your book as well. I'll show you in one of the slides. It's your choice. You can learn the definitions from there as well, or you can write them down side by side so that you don't forget to learn them, right? It's your choice, but do that, please. Underline these points on page 3 of your book, and It's a Fact on page number 4, right? Here is the text of your World Watch 1 which we have covered till now. Underline these points on page number 3 of your book, and It's a Fact on page number 4 of your books. This is page number 3 and this is page number 4. We have studied about the stars. Please go through the whole paragraph. You should be able to answer after reading it that, do stars move? Yes or no? And if they move, why don't we feel their movement? So you should be able to answer this question after reading this whole paragraph. Coming towards the galaxies, underline the definition of galaxy. A galaxy is a collection of stars, nebulae, and other materials held together by the galaxy's gravity. Now, over here, the role of gravity is really important. I've already told you people that each and every object in the space has its own gravity. The difference between nebula and galaxy is that galaxy's elements or galaxy's things, they are held together, and they have and galaxy has a center of gravity, whereas that nebula also has a center of gravity, but nebula results in the formation of stars and the planets. Then our galaxy is the Milky Way. Sun is one of its stars. Small galaxies move in an orbit around bigger galaxies. The nearest is the Large Magellanic Cloud, which was discovered by a Persian astronomer, Abdul Rahman Sufi, more than 1,000 years ago. This is important, you have to underline it. Then on next page, it's a fact. Here is the difference between nebula and a galaxy. You can be asked this question: what is the difference between nebula and a galaxy? And here is its answer. You can answer it after, you know, learning it from here. I hope this is clear, right? Now, here is your spot test where you can test or check your understanding. You can assess yourself. You can do these question answers on your rough notebook and then you can check them yourself. This is just the way we used to assess at the end of the lesson. So, this is what you will do yourself. I'll read out each and every question for you and I'll explain you. How can you justify that the stars move, though their movement cannot be felt? The meaning of this question is that the stars move. This is what this question is saying itself, that the stars do move, but how can you say that they move even though you cannot feel the movement of the stars? So this is what you are supposed to answer in your own words. Number two, do you think a galaxy is different from a nebula? First of all, you will write down yes or no. If you think it's different from a nebula, how? You have to give a reason. Number three, can you think of another word for orbit? We have already done the definition of orbit. Keep in mind that definition and think of another word which can be used instead of word orbit. This is what you have to do on your rough notebooks, and then you can go through, you can discuss these questions with me in the Zoom class, but this is not your actual written work, okay? This is just an assessment at the end of the lesson. Your task for day one is you will revise last week's lecture. That's really important. After going through this lecture till you know the last slide, you will read page number 3 and 4. You'll do the spot test to assess yourself, and obviously you'll revise all the highlighted points. Let's now move on to our next topic, which is on page number 4 of your World Watch 1. How did our solar system form? You're supposed to write down the date the way you used to do in your class. But before we proceed, I would just like to ask you a few questions. If I would really appreciate if you people write down the answers on your rough notebook. I'll give you a few seconds to write down whatever comes in your mind and then check whether your answer is correct or not. Here is your first question. Can you see the planets in the night sky? Think about the formation of planets, you know. Just say yes or no, write it down. Think about the formation of the planets. The planets formed from the rocks. Do rocks have their lights? Do rocks have light? Okay. N All right. So let's see the next question and then we'll answer all of them. Do you know how are you able to see the planets, though they have no light of their own? Okay, now the answer to the first question was, can you see the planets in the night sky? The answer is yes, you can see the planets in the night sky. Just think about planet Venus. I told you people that it is the brightest object. It can be seen in the night sky. Now the next question comes, why is it so that you are able to see the planets, though you know that planets don't have their own light? Whatever comes in your mind, quickly write it down. The answer is they reflect the sunlight. The way moon reflects sunlight, in the same way, planets don't have their own light, but when sun rays fall on the planets, they reflect sunlight, and this is how you are able to see the planets in the night sky. My last question is, why do stars shine? Why do they shine? Think about their composition, their formation from the nebula. Yes, because they are composed of burning gases. Very good. All right. Okay, one more thing we are supposed to learn over here is planets of our solar system. Please learn the names of the solar system's planets in an order. Mercury is the first one, then Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, the largest planet, Saturn, known for its rings, Uranus, and Neptune. So your another task is to learn the names of the planets of the solar system, and I'll be asking the names of the planets of the solar system in the Zoom class. So get ready for that as well. Over here, before we start to study how did our solar system form or what keeps the planets stay in their orbits, it is important to understand the concept of gravity. You people have done it in grade 5 as well in science, but just to revise it, you can do this activity. Hold any object in your hand, like your pencil or your pen, or make a ball of paper. Don't take anything that can be broken down, that can break into pieces, and just leave it from your hand. Let it go off your hand. What happens if you let go of it? What will happen if you have anything and you just release it from your hand? Yes, it will fall down. It will fall to the ground. So my next question is, what makes it fall to the ground? The answer is there is some force which is attracting it towards the earth. So the earth's gravity is that force. The earth's gravity pulls it. So the gravity affects how anything moves in the space. I have told you earlier as well that all the heavenly bodies are having their own gravity. So all the objects which are in the space, they are attracting the smaller objects towards them. Like sun is a bigger star, so sun is trying to attract the planets towards it, right? The planets have their own gravity, right? And the planets are trying to attract other objects towards them. So because of force of gravity, everything is moving in the space in an order. Everything is moving at its own on its own path. It's not moving here and there, right? So understanding gravity is very important, as gravity plays a vital role in the movement of the objects in the space. How did our solar system form? This is given on page number 4 of your book. First, listen to the lecture that I'm giving, and then you will move towards your book and you will underline important points. We have studied it earlier in revision presentation as well, that our solar system was formed about 4.6 billion years ago, and we also studied that sun has the ability to emit its radiations for 5 billion years more. So that means that our solar system has is in the middle of its life. It has passed half of its life, right? Sun is the major star of our solar system, and there are 8 planets which are revolving around the sun in their orbits, and all the planets have their own moons. There are some planets which have no moons of their own, like Mercury and Venus, but the other planets have the different number of moons, like Earth has one, Mars has two, there are some which have 14, 52, 87. There are so many moons which mostly the planets are having. Okay, what about other heavenly bodies? We cannot say that only star, sun, planets and moons, they make up the solar system. There are other heavenly bodies as well. Can you tell me about some other heavenly bodies which we have discussed in our revision presentation, which was about solar system? Yes, we studied about the asteroids, we studied about the comets, we studied about the meteoroids. Then there are certain other dwarf planets along with these things. There are certain rocks. So these all heavenly bodies, they comprise to form the solar system. Remember this thing. Now here comes the formation of the solar system. How was our solar system form? We have already discussed this thing, that nebula is actually a cloud of gases, dust, and rock, right? Nebula is a cloud of gases, dust, and rock. Okay. Now, we have also studied about the formation of the stars. So, Sun is the major star of our solar system. So, we can say that the star formed from a nebula. And which part of nebula? These gases. These gases formed the star. Now, the gases have formed the star. When the star is formed, there are other materials like dust and rock and other things which are still there in the nebula. Gases have turned into a star, but still dust, rock and some other materials are still there in the nebula, which are constantly moving around the nebula. Okay, they keep on breaking and they keep on falling, they keep on merging with one another. Like the smaller rocks, they take many years to combine and to form bigger bodies. Some of the rocks, they remain in smaller size. So this is how, the other material, it is joined together. Then comes the role of the gravity. All those materials which are left in the nebula after the formation of the star. Now remember, star is there. Now star is going to play the role of its gravity. Okay, now when Sun was formed from the nebula, Sun had its gravity. Now Sun will attract all the other objects of the nebula towards itself. Okay, like dust, like rocks, like certain other leftover gases. Sun is having gravity. It will try to attract everything towards itself. And during that attraction force, it will pull the materials which will join together and they will grow to form the planets, right? So the planets are formed from nebula, from the rocks and other solid material. Important point over here is the difference between the planets and the stars. I have already discussed stars with you people that they are made up of gases, burning gases. Because of that, those burning gases, the stars shine brightly. And the stars do not orbit the planets. Rather than that the planets orbit the stars. On the other hand, planets are made up of rocks. They do not shine, or they do not have their own light, you can say, and they orbit the stars. So once more revising it, that the solar system formed from the nebula. What is a nebula? It is a cloud of gases, dust and rock. The gases formed the star. We have already studied about how a star is formed. The temperature rises and the fragments and the pieces, they break and fall into the center and all that procedure. So once the Sun has formed, now Sun has its own gravity, right? And it has masses of other material from the nebula around it as well. Now the Sun will start to pull those things, that material which has dust, rock, towards itself. In that procedure of pulling everything towards itself, certain rocks will hit one another and they can combine to form bigger objects. Those bigger objects which are made up of rocks and solid material, they will form the planets. And the moons were also formed in the same way. The ones which were able to join, the rocks which joined together to form bigger rocks, they became the planets and they started orbiting the sun. Now, once the planet has formed, the planet has its own gravity as well. So the other smaller rocks could have been attracted by those planets and they became their moons. Now, like Mercury and Venus, they are very close to the sun. They are the closest to the sun. They are more influenced by the gravity of the sun. So they were unable to, maybe they were unable to attract any rock or any moon towards themselves. That is why Mercury and Venus have no moons. Earth is a third planet. Earth has one moon. It's a bit larger in size as well. So it was able to attract only one moon. Talking about Mars, Mars is not that big in size, right? But as it is far away from the sun, a little far away from the sun as compared to Earth, it managed to attract more number of moons. It has two moons. Then Jupiter is the largest. It must have attracted certain rocks which became moon. So this is how the solar system was formed. All this information is given on page number 4 of your books. This is the demonstration or a formation of our solar system. This is not in your book, but it's easy when you see the formation through a diagram. Look at this. This is a cloud of dust, gases, and other materials, rocks. It is known as nebula. This is the first stage when nebula is in its original shape. Okay, then number two, these are the other materials which are held by the gravity. Gravity of what? Gravity of the nebula, right? They're not moving here and there. They're constantly moving, like whirling around, and the pieces and the fragments are falling in the middle. And you can see that gases have formed this star. This is the first stage, how our solar system was formed. Then the next is, can you see this now? The planets are forming, right? Continuously, the rocks are combining together and they are forming the planets. Now, as this planet has formed, now this planet has its center of gravity as well. It will start to pull the smaller objects towards itself, and maybe that those objects will become the moons. Some of them can become asteroids, and they can keep on moving around the planet in their orbits, right? Now, over here, what is this? These two are the planets which are moving in an orbit due to the gravity of the sun. These are the planets which are moving, right? Now read the topic, how did our solar system form, which is on page number 4 of your books. Note down anything which is not understandable, and you can discuss that in Zoom class. Underline some important points that I'll explain you in the next slide, right? This is page number 4 of your books. The material which is highlighted in blue ink tells you how did our solar system form, okay? So if the question is about the formation of the solar system or the formation of the planets, you are supposed to write down this. It has the same information that I have explained you earlier, that, you know, when sun was formed, it had some other materials of gases and dust which kept on moving around, and after some time they broke off, they carried on moving, and because of the gravity they were pulled, and then they grew large enough to become the planets. So this is how the planets were formed. Please focus on this concept. Then the ones which are highlighted in yellow, this is important for objective, that the solar system began to form about 4.6 billion years ago. Gases became the sun, which were in the nebula. The planets were formed from the rocks and other solid materials. This is important, and it's a fact you people have already underlined. And then if you look at this picture, this is a picture of Orion Nebula, which has come from Hubble telescope. Hubble telescope is a telescope which is an artificial satellite, it's taking pictures and sending it to the Earth. It's important over here to focus on this concept. Please focus on how did the solar system form, right? Here is your task for day 2. This is what you are supposed to do. You have to revise what is gravity with the help of the activity which is mentioned. Draw the solar system on your rough notebook and bring it along in the Zoom class. Then read page number 4 and revise the concepts which are taught. On page number 4, we have discussed how did our solar system form. Alright, from here your day 3 work starts. This is your written work. At the end of the lesson, you should be able to answer all these questions. If you have gone through the lecture, you have read the book, and you have tried to attempt each and every activity, it's not going to be difficult for you. But still, I'll be explaining you each and every question. Our question number 1 is, define the following. You are supposed to define galaxy in a very good way. Define gravity. Define orbit. Right, all these definitions are marked in your book. They are in the glossary as well. I have added them in the presentation as well, right? Your second question is, how is a galaxy different from a nebula? You people have marked it on page number 4. It's a fact. You're supposed to mention that difference. You have practiced it in spot test as well, right? Your third question is, how do the scientists think the planets form? Now, this is a little long question. You people are supposed to go through the topic, how did our solar system form, on page number 4, right? And this is mentioned in mainly the end of the first paragraph and the second paragraph. I would appreciate if you people write it down in your own words. If you think that reading from the book and writing from there is difficult, you can go through the slide where I have explained the formation of the planets, and you people can write down your understanding from there as well. I would appreciate if you people write down in your own words, but please don't miss out any important point. Obviously, definitions cannot be written in your own words, so don't change them, right? But this can be done. And don't forget to learn all these things. If while learning you are unable to understand anything, please note it down and bring it along to be discussed in the Zoom class, right? All the questions answers are in the presentation and lecture. You have marked them, but still, if there is something which is not clear, I am repeating again and again. Please note them down and discuss with me in the Zoom class. And yes, do come prepared, you know, for the activities and discussion to be done in the Zoom class. Let's just review once whatever we have done in this presentation. We have studied about stars and their movement. We have studied that stars do move, but we hardly feel the movement of the stars. Then we studied about the galaxies and the difference between a galaxy and a nebula. We also studied about the formation of the planets of the solar system. How did they form? And at the end, you people did your written work, which was done very nicely. All right. This is all from this week's lecture. I would appreciate you people to bring your questions along in the Zoom class so that we can discuss and all of your queries can be resolved. Thank you very much.